Rav Chaim Yaakov Tsukerman, a geweldige sefer called Otzer Chaim. And he writes in his Otzer Chaim as follows. There are chassidim, there are misnagdim. And we know that one of the manifestations of that distinction is that chassidim and those who daven, Nusa Sfar, they begin Psukei Dezimra with Hodu. Amar Sheikin, the Misnagdim, how do they commence Psukei Dezimra with Baruch Shamar? So you have one group, they start with Hodu, they're thanking the Ribbono Shel Olam, the other one, Baruch Shamar, they're starting with Divrei, Ashvach, Divrei Brucha, and they start perhaps at different points, but where do they meet? You know what unites, what merges them both? When you get to Yehi Chavod Hashem Li'olam, then the Ashkenazim, the Sfardim, the Misnagdim, the Hasidim, everybody comes together. And when you get to Hi Chavod, when Kisham Adubar Mekovit Shamayim, Ayesh Lachta Mekoch Hilukei Anishchos Vahadeus Uzislake Lekoch Echad, we jettison, we put aside all the differences, all the points of conflict, and we merge, refuse together. Why? We want to forever protect the Kovet Shemayim. Klai Yisrael getting together, Yichavon Hashem Li'olam. That's the Iker. That's what life is all about. Kabbalos Omochu Shemayim. So Tsukerman continues in the Otzer Chaim Gevaldik. He said the story is told of a Chassidish Rebbe. And he took a huge lamed and a massive Talmid Chacham who happened to be the son of a well-known misnagid. Oy Vesmir, a Chassidish Rebbe for his daughter. And he's taking albeit the lamed and a choshev Talmid Chacham, a tzaddik. Aye, but he's the son of a renowned misnagid. So the Chassidim asked and they said, Rebbe, how can you take a misnagid for the choshev, for your son-in-law? And he said as follows. He says, my nafkamina, whether he starts his psukin izimra with Hodu, or whether he starts his psukin izimra with Baal Shamar, he says, but to Lamaisa, when we get to Kriyashma, to Kabbalah Sochu Shemayim, everybody davens to the same God above, Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad, Yehi Chavod Hashem Li'olam. You didn't have to wait until Shema. Already, Yehi Chavod Hashem Li'olam. Oh, but what did he tell us, Chassidim? In the end of the day, what unites Klai Yisrael? We have one God, and we dive into that one God, to that one Ribbono Shel Olam. And it renews itself year after year, davening to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and a sense of being Mamlech L'Yebishter. The Ikar Avodah Sayom, of course, as the Gemara relates, and Rosh Hashanah to Zayin Man Aleph, what do we do? Irma Lefone, Malchios Kedisha, Tam Lichuni Aleichem. Selevi Zechreinas, we want Shiyal Zechonechem Lefonei, Ubamel B'Shoifar, always bringing up the idea of HaKadosh Yitzchok, Ebishter. How we want to reenact, we want to re-experience what Yitzchok did. All of me belongs to all of you. The total hispatlus, hachno, gemuru, machletes, utter subjugation and subservience before the Almighty above. I'm not living for me, I'm living for the Ribbono Shel Olam. That's the ikar mahus, the ikar essence of the day. Emer lefoni, malchios kedisha, tam lichuni aleichem. Writes a Chaim Volozhin in the Siddur HaGro when he introduces the tefillahs for the Yom Neroi. Explains a Chaim Volozhin the Iker Kavono to have in mind when you stand up. I'm before the Ebershter. Yes, every time you stand in davening. What is davening? Dol lefnei mi atomei. Ah, davening is the famous of Chaim Brisker, Chedush HaGracha L'Rambam, and Ilchus Tefillah Paragdala Locha Aleph, that even more, that's Likufa, and not the Perish Amilim, even if you don't understand every word of davening, you still, you'd see the Din of Tefillah. But if you're not aware, you're standing in front of the Melech Malchei Melochim. And you don't have the basic form of the Tzuras HaTefillah, the acknowledgement, the recognition, the awareness, that full, found, profound cognizance that I'm standing before the Almighty. He's right here with me, right here opposite me. If you're not aware that you're standing in front of the HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Melech Malchim Elokim, then you haven't defined your tefillah as a tefillah. It doesn't get off the ground. You can have all the kavanah in the interpretation of what the words mean, but you got to know what you're doing in the first place. You're standing in front of God. And that's shaykh every single day of the year, every single tefillah. The Iker Kavone, however, to have a mind by Yom Narom, writes a Chaim Voloshin, and the Sidur HaGro is, I'm not davening for me. That's why Halacha L'Maisa, it's not about Rosh Hashanah, your personal Makash is God. Can I have this? Can I have that? I want to have money. I want to have a spouse. I want to have children. I want health. I want gezud. It's not about davening for your personal needs. It's about davening to be Mamlecha Kodesh Baruch Hu Asei Laman Chalot. I'm davening to give a quote Shemayim. That is the common denominator. I threw out all the tefillahs of the Yom Narom. It's not about me. It's about Klal Yisrael, yes, but it's first and foremost about the covenant of Kodesh Baruch Hu. And in fact, the Chavetz Chaim writes that every time we daven for your Moshe Mashiach, if you think about it, it's not necessarily great, writes the Chavetz Chaim, a Kamadukti in several places. That Bias Kol Tzedek, it's not that it's great for the individual. For the individual, once Mashiach comes and the MS is rampant, rife throughout the land, and the whole world knows it's Moli Deyas, everybody knows God, and everybody knows the Torah is MS. And then big deal, to be a Jew, to be an El Chayid, everyone's going to be learning Torah. Everyone's going to be running to learn Torah, to do mitzvahs. Amai Sim Tovim Mechiru Chavshis is not the same. The Sugin Yavamas, they were not Mekabel, they didn't accept Gerim and Meidobu to Shlomo, and Nochamo likewise, they will not accept Gerim when Mashiach comes. Why? Because the emes is staring at you in the face. Veracity of Torah, of Yiddishkeit, it's all going to be so lucid, so ever transparent. There's no need science. What are we davening for? You know, Yemos Mashiach is all about, it's not about your personal covet. You can't steig the same way in the sense that you don't get the same schar because the emes is right there. It mela diminishes your sense of free will. When the emes is ever so clear and transparent. So what's it about? It's about Yemos Mashiach. Why? Because we daven more for the covet of a Kodesh Baruch Hu, for the covet of Klal Yisrael, that the world's going to know Mi Kam Chayisol Gayecha Ba'aretz, in our land, our homeland, with the Almighty, with the Beis Hamikdash, with the glorious Bayis Amafur, the Holy Temple. The world's going to see. Yes, we are the Amah Nilchar, with the Amah Sekula, and God is the only God, the Omniscient, Omnipotent Creator of all. That's what they're going to see. That's what we daven for, and that especially is the highlight of Rosh Hashanah. Rosh Hashanah, it's not about me. It's not about why my wants and my desires and all the things that I feel that I need. What's Rosh Hashanah? The tachlis is I'm davening for Kvod Shemayim. I'm davening Imru L'fonei Malchios Kiryas Shatam Lichuni Aleichem. That's a common thread woven throughout the tapestry of all the glorious tefillos of the Yom Narayim. It's about God. It's about Klal Yisrael. It's about the Shofar. It's about Akedas Yitzchak. It's about the willingness to sacrifice yourselves on an altar and say it's not about my life. It's about the glory of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. The Shame Kavod Malchuso in this world. The culmination of all the Yom Narom is what? Is Yom Kippur, the climax of the Aser Semit Tshuva, the Avodah. That all took place commencing ready with Chodesh Elul. It all comes to a close and it reaches its climax with what? With Baruch Shame Kavod Malchuso, the Elavad, that we're all like celestial angels, like God's Malachi Yashareis. And in Yom Kippur, the culmination of the whole Avodah that we started Rosh Chodesh Elul, it all comes to together and what and sing for a glorious in unison out loud Baruch Shem Kivon Machus the Olam Void. That is the Tachlis Abriya, and that's what we do in Rosh Hashanah. Yes, Rav Gedalia Shor writes in the very beginning of Or Gedalia on the Modem, when he talks about Rosh Hashanah, we recite every day, of course, Adon Olam Hashem Molach, B'terem Kol Yitzin Avra, said the Eivishter already was a Melach, I, Perkin Elozer, a Mel, Rabbeinu Bachai, and others, a Melach below Am. Terah says there are two Musogim of Malchus, Savad, that God is a Melach, Beinola, Veinatzmo, Kaviyocho, God is a Melach. We don't understand what it means to be a Melach before God created the world. God is the Melach, Be'etzim Atzmi Yusuf, Kvoda Yisparach, he's a Melach. Aba what? B'terem Kol Shetz, but then, as I melech Shimon Ekra, as I melech Shimon Ekra, when are you going to call on melech when there's an Am? Who's the Am? We're the Am HaNikr, the Am HaSegula. How Iker Tachlis in being created as the Am HaNikr, the Am HaSegula is to call out the Malchus of the Bari Olam and to let the world know, to disseminate the Amitas HaDvarim, the Amitas HaTorah, the veracity, the truth of the Torah, of the mitzvahs, to spread to be the Or L'Gayim, disseminate and promulgate the covenant of HaKadosh Baruch Hu and the covenant of Klal Yisrael the world over. That's what we have to do when we pre-press once again the reset button. Comes Hayom HaRasolam Odom Rishon. It's a chance to be reborn again, so to speak. And what's the Tachas Abriya? Be Mamlech Hashem Yisproch like never before. And thus we understand why we have a well-known Mishnah in Maseches Rosh Hashanah Chavtesim and Aleph. And the Mishnah talks about the Mechemes Amalek, about the story that took place, Perk Yitzai, in the end of Parshas Meshalach. And in the same Mishnah, we talk about the Nachash HaNachoshes, on the pages of Parshas Chukas. And the Mishnah questions, I, Moshe Rabbeinu, the Torah says in the end of Mishalach L'chasher, Yara Moshe S'yodu B'gavah Yisrael, K'asher Aniyach S'yodu B'gavah Amalek. Frank, the Mishnah, the Tana asks, V'chi Yadu Shomai Sha'osus M'chama Shos M'chama, Elok Shayim Estakla M'shadim Aslevim N'shamayim, then we would emerge victorious. Of a war when we stop paying attention to God, how we put our faith into Kochi V'otzim Yodi, how we said it's because of our swords and our shields and our bows and arrows and our weaponry. That's when we made that grave mistake. That's when we lose the war. How do you win the war when you mistake El Shmai? And you look up to the heavens above and you recognize who's going to allow me to emerge victorious or not. It's contingent on one and one single variable, the one factor that determines who's going to win the war. Are you being Meshabi yourself as an Eved, recognizing the only way you're going to win against Amalek is Achrak with the Siyata Nishmaya from the Almighty above. Similarly, Nachash Nechayshis, what happens? They got bitten by the Nechash Masrofim. You look at the copper snake sitting on the staff. Again, recognizing your health, everything is in the hands of God. Say, yes, vaccines, not vaccines. How much time is it? Leave it, yes, to the doctors. Leave it, yes, to the experts. In the end of the day, follow your rabbi, follow your rabbanim. Do what you need to ask your shayla v'chule. But Rabbi said, the people, everyone getting so heated and so vehement. Rabbi said, in the end of the day, daven. And it's a Kodesh Baruch Hu. Say yes, whether you take the vaccine or you don't take the vaccine, you have antibodies, not taking antibodies. Again, you'll ask your Shaila, but what do we have to have in mind? Abishter is the one running the show. If COVID taught us anything, the Abishter is in control. The Melech Malchim, Melechim, the Eino Mavado. And Rosh Hashanah teaches us to reset our focus and reshift our perspective on life. It's all about the Kodesh Baruch Hu and it's about his COVID. It's not about us beating Amalek. It's not about the Nochash, about being Nitzel from Mitzori, you know what's going to do it. Shayim Estaklim, Meshavdim Eslivim, the Shamayim writes, Matas Yo Solomon, Adalekur Meshkiach, and Zgavaldi Gesei for Manas Chayim. Based on the Tiferes Yisrael on that mission, Rosh Hashanah Chavtes, Tiferes Yisrael writes that the mission is teaching us whether you ask to daven to be Matzliach, like in the context of Mechemes Amalek, whether you daven to be saved from Mitzora, like in the case of Chukas, the Nechosh Masrofi, or whatever it is, Eina Tfila Nishmas, King Kishem Iskavi, Sheikhaskeyu Hashem, Lavodosi Yisborach. It comes down to what I'm asking Hashem to strengthen me as an Eved Hashem, the greater, the bigger, the better Eved Hashem that you are. That's what's going to determine you're going to be allowed to win against an Amalek, against all your adversaries in life. You're going to be Nitzel from Mitzora. How much of an Eved Hashem are you? Are you acting L'Shem Shemayim? Are you Kavanos L'Shem Shemayim? Right, to Matthias Yael Solomon, yes, that's the first soul is telling us that idea and a concept of tefillah, but it applies to everything in life, everything we do in life. Are we eating because, we love fish, we love the steak, drinking the wine, because what are we eating? What are we drinking for? What are we going on vacation for? For own pleasure, our own covet, our own glory, our own sense of chilling and relaxing. Are we doing it to strengthen ourselves as an Eved Hashem? I need to eat, I need to drink, and yes, sometimes you have to go on vacation. Why? And I've been asked to be machasing myself so I can come back stronger, healthier, reinvigorated, refreshing, and replenishing the kaychas so I could serve the Abishol like never before. Changes the whole focus. Chavetz Chaim says you can have two people after Shabbos lunch. And one says, Gevaldik, Shabbos lunch, a nice Shabbos afternoon. It was a great shulant, great Diet Coke, seltzer at the table. It was great. The potato cocoa was delicious. Now let me hit the sack. And you tell, wake me up for mincha. Wake me up. Whenever I get up, I get up. So the person goes to sleep, takes a nap. He didn't do any averus, but he didn't get any schar. The next guy goes to sleep for the same amount of time. But before he hits the sack, before he goes at the bed, he says, hey, mister, I'm sleeping. You want me to get Onik Shabbos, Peseda Gummer. I'm lying down now to get Onik Shabbos. And I'm lying down to Koychus. I can get up for the Rav Shir. I can get up for Mincha. I can get up to have more Kavan in my davening. I can get up to learn better this afternoon. Two people sleeping the same time for the same duration. And one gets zero brownie points in the heaven chalkboards above. And the other one is chalking up brownie point after brownie point for every second that he's sleeping. Why? What's your Kavan? What's your driving force of your actions? Is it to be an Eved Hashem? Or is it it stopped to take care of your own needs, your own greeds, your own desires, your own wants. That's Rosh Hashanah, Yom HaSolem. It's time to be reborn again. So here we are in the threshold. We're about to re-experience rebirth. Rabbeisai, who are we living for? Are we living for ourselves? Do we want the homes, the cars, the vacations, the steaks, the pizzas? What do we want? The watches, the clothing, the golfing, the tennis, the swimming. What do we want it all for? Because we want to take care of ourselves and we want to be strong and healthy and hale. So that we could serve the Ribbono Shel Olam with learning Torah with Asiyas HaMitzvos and Ma'asim Tovim. Rosh Hashanah is Hayom HaRasolim. We get a chance to say, it's time to start over. Clean slate. Eivishter Tshuva, I'm coming back home. I'm coming back to you and I'm ready to daven and I'm ready to live life. Starting with a clean slate. Starting from scratch. I'm not going to live now. I'm not going to eat and I'm not going to daven. I'm not going to daven to you. Rosh Hashanah, put your own makoshes aside. It's not, but Hashem, I need this house and I need this car and I need this vacation. I forget, Rabbi, so that's Tanugi Ol Mazi. You're not davening for that. You're not davening for the vacations and the watches and the homes and the clothing and the jewelry and the food. You're davening Hashem. I want good shalom bayis and I want healthy children and I want that. Who's that still for? You're right, you made a ruchniyistik, but it's still about you. Rosh Hashanah is, I'm putting aside my own focus, my own self-centeredness. Rosh Hashanah says it's about Kvodo Yisborach. It's about the Yisod is, and that's why perhaps this very mission is where Dafkin Meseches Rosh Hashanah Kefiru Tzedek Kohen and Rosh Hashanah, when the whole Avodah Seyom is Zimra Lefonei Malchios Kedesh Shatam Lechuni Alechem, we can understand this is a time to daven not for our own needs, Bein Beruchnius and Bein Begashmius. It's a time to shift that focus. Eivishter, I want to live for you. I want to love you. I want to be healthy. I want to be around this year. I want to live through Rosh Hashanah. Why? Because there's more that I could do to spread the covet of the Borei Olam, to spread the beauty of Yiddishkeit, of Torah Mitzvahs the world over. I want to make a Kiddush Hashem with everything and every single thing that I say, that I do, and that I ask for. It's all the mancha. It's for you. It's not for us. And when you daven for a Kodesh Ruchu, when you give up for a Kodesh Ruchu, hein lecha schus gedola mizu, that's the way to be nitzel b'din. That's the way to be zuchus yad l'shmai. God says, you're giving up your own needs, your own wants, like the Meshech Chochma when Rosh Hashanah coincides with Shabbos, you give up Shofar. Frank, what do you mean you give up Shofar? That's the biggest achus. You're giving up the mitzvah sayom to not have anybody transgress Hashem Shabbos. That schus itself is what makes us be nitzel b'din. Rosh Hashanah is, it's not about me. It's not about my family. It's not about even my ruchnius. It's about the covet of the melech, malchim, and malachim. So let's get ready. Let's get set to be mamlech the Borei Olam like never before. Klai Yisos, the Yama Nivchor with the Yama Segula, and we're the nation that was handpicked by the Almighty above to be mamlech HaKadosh Baruch Hu year after year. Let's not let him down. Let's not disappoint. Let's say those machios like never before. Ksiva chasim toivan, a good kevetch dior.